Hello everyone, myself Fatima. I hope you all are doing well. So in previous lecture, I have talked about exception handling in Python, then how you can raise custom exceptions, which is also known as user-defined exception in Python. And today I will explain the assert statement in Python and how it will work. So first of all, what is assert statement? So it will work like a Boolean expression based on the given condition. Like if you have given some condition and if it is true, then next statement will be get executed. But if the condition is false, then it will throws an exceptions. So mainly this assert statement will be useful for developer as well as third party user also. We'll see how it will useful for both. So this is the syntax for assert statement. You can use assert statement with error message and without error message also. If you have not include the error message, then it will give default error message like assert error kind of thing. But if you have include proper error message for third party user, so that will be helpful to that third party user to understand why such kind of error will occur. Okay, so let us move on to direct practical part and we'll see how it will work. So first of all, give heading assert statement. Okay, so we'll continue with that exception divide by zero. I know there are so many other exceptions are also there, but if we keep the continuity, it will be helpful and it will clear the concept in better way. So that's why I'm sticking to one example only. So here first take one variable, integer input, enter first number, and this will be my first number which will be divisible. So here number, and second b is equal to integer, which will become my denominator. So input, enter second number. Okay, so this is work as denominator. Okay, now how you can use assert statement? So there are two ways you can use it. You can use directly here, and if you want to create a function, then you want to use that inside a function, that is also good. Both the ways it is acceptable and it is true. So for example, I am creating one function definition. So you can create a function by using def keyword. Suppose I am giving the name of function division, then passing two arguments here, x comma y. So to avoid the naming conflict, I am giving separate, or I am giving different variable name here. Now here assert, how you can raise a condition, how you can use assert statement. So carefully see here. One, first you have to insert assert keyword. Make sure the spelling is correct as well as the capital small thing is also correct. Then here you have to write some condition. Okay, so suppose I am writing the condition y is not equal to 0. This is my condition. So if this is true, it will directly go to next statement. So here my next statement would be x divided by y. Then you can print whatever the answer is. So here you can answer, you can print C, which is your answer, and then don't forget to call the function, otherwise it is useless thing. So division, and when you call the function, pass the argument A comma B. So here whatever the value enter by user, which is stored in A and B, and when you call the function division, it will replaced with X and Y. So let us check how it will works. So here I have taken first one syntax in which I am not giving any error message. I simply give some condition in assert statement. So let us see how it will work. So first of all 12, and suppose I am giving here 0. So this kind of error will occur, and this is the important one, assertion error. So here you can see that assertion error. Here I have not given any proper message. Now if you want to give any proper message, just you have to include comma and then in double quote you can write your message. So I am writing divide by zero, not possible, comma, enter valid denominator. Okay, so this will become my error message. So now run your module. Suppose same thing I am giving as an input. Okay, so see here, assertion error, divide by zero, not possible, please enter valid denominator. Okay, so this is specifically useful to give some error message in a proper way. Okay, so this is how you can use assert statement. So to sum up all this thing and previous two videos, exception handling are divided into three portion. We can say that first you can use try catch block for exception handling. Second, you can use raise keyword with or without function. And third, you can also use assert statement for exception handling. So the whole exception handling is divided into three portion. And in this video, exception handling are over. If you like this video, press the like button, share with your friend, which will be helpful to them also, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. We'll see you in next video. Till then, bye-bye.